1991, the Air Jordan 6 released to the public consisted of 5 colorways, 2 of which contained infrared, the black and white infrared, 2 very popular colorways. Now, we saw the black infrared pretty recently in 2019. However, we haven't seen the white infrared Jordan 6 since 2014. So Nike being Nike, instead of bringing back the Jordan 6 white infrared, one of the best Jordan 6s, they took the colorway, the beloved colorway, and they just dumped it on another shoe. Now, while I would have loved the Jordan 6 white infrared to make a reappearance, I do actually like this colorway on this shoe. Air Jordan 7 white infrared. Now, this shoe is dropping on June 30th for $200 in the United States. And right off the bat, you just cannot deny the cleanness, the beauty of the white infrared colorway. It just looks so good. I think out of the black infrared and white infrared, definitely prefer the white infrared. Even though it's not on the Jordan 6, this shoe is clean. Definitely is clean. Currently, I only own one pair of Jordan 7s, and that's the Jordan 7 Cardinal. Love that colorway. In terms of the colorway itself in a vacuum, I like the white infrared, but I think the Jordan 7 Cardinal's slightly better. And the Jordan 7, if you didn't know, was inspired by African tribal artwork. So you see like the spikes on the midsole coming up into the upper sole of the shoe. It's more like an eclectic pattern, and I really, really dig it. That's my favorite thing about the Jordan 7. And you also see that influence on the booty of the shoe. So you see like this upside down triangle shape almost with the number 23 on the booty. Love that. And the upper sole of the shoe, a completely white base leather layer. While the leather's nice, the tumble texture on the shoe is just overdone. Look how artificial it makes the shoe look. Apart from the overlays, the tumble texture is just, this is too much. This is like the Jordan 3 Unites where it just, come on, just make it look more natural. Just let the leather, kind of the pattern of the leather and the grain of the leather just naturally come through. This is just, oof, I don't love that. You know that phobia? I definitely have this phobia where you see a lot of little holes together and your body just like shrinks and you feel gross. This tumbled leather, the way this is done, gives me that same feeling. I do not like it. Now, the Jordan 7 was also the first shoe that didn't feature any reference to Nike. So Tinker Hatfield and Jordan Brand really wanted to distinguish Air Jordan as its own thing. So I didn't want to reference Nike at all. Now I say that, but then on the insole, it has a Nike Air Brandon insole. They just destroyed the whole point. And you'll also notice there's no visible air unit on this shoe. It's the first Jordan shoe to not have a visible air unit. I believe from the Jordan 3 to the Jordan 6, every single one of those shoes had a Nike Air unit. Jordan 7, they were like done with Nike. The visible air unit is too synonymous with Nike, so we're not going with that. It wasn't until the Jordan 16s they brought back the visible air unit. Speaking of air units, this shoe does come with an encapsulated air unit, a full-length air unit, so the cushioning is very decent on this shoe. And the outsole, a very, very beautiful pattern. Again, influenced by African tribal artwork. You can see the shapes and color clearly has that influence. Really, really love that, and really love how the infrared just shines through, that pops through. And in combination with this icy translucent outsole, oof, this is beautiful, truly beautiful. Now the padding inside the shoe, it is made out of neoprene. Now around this time, Tinker Hatfield designed the Airflight Huarache that I just reviewed pretty recently. He was inspired when he went on a water skiing trip. So he was wearing water skiing boots that was made out of neoprene. He liked the fit, he liked the comfort, so he brought that to the Jordan 7s as well. I do really like that neoprene material. The comfort of the Airflight Huaraches, they were so nice on my feet, just like wraps around your feet. And it's the same with the Jordan 7s. I have more to say on comfort later. It's not perfect, but the neoprene in a vacuum, I really like it. And one thing I gotta point out about the Jordan 7s are the shoe trees that they use. I prefer it way, way, way over that just bunch of paper they just stuff in the shoe. This looks so much nicer, so much cleaner, so much easier to handle. Now the tongue of the shoe, also a very unique looking tongue, has air in the middle and between the letters of Jordan. Now what's interesting about the shoe is not only did they borrow and take an OG colorway from the Jordan 6, I also feel like the Jordan 7 silhouette is very similar to the Jordan 6. Just in a vacuum at a quick glance, apart from the visible air unit, obviously it doesn't have that on the Jordan 7s, I feel like the shape is pretty similar. The Jordan 6 also has this heel tab on the back, The Jordan 6, it is a solid heel tab in that TPU kind of rubber, hardened rubber material. This one, obviously, more of a traditional heel tab, but I feel like the silhouette is very similar. So the white infrared actually kind of fits this shoe pretty well. This shoe doesn't come with any extra laces. I feel like black laces might actually give this shoe a little bit of a pop, but I'm fine with the white default laces. Kind of makes the shoe look cleaner, just sleeker, but as someone that appreciates extras or free things, would have appreciated extra laces, even though I wouldn't have used them. Box of the shoe, super, super normal, standard Jordan box. Now moving on to size and comfort, I'm a size 9.5 true to size. I do have wide feet. For this shoe, I go up half a size to size 10, and I always go up half a size for Jordan 7s. Now there's a few reasons for that. Number one, the Jordan 7 is a pretty slender and narrow silhouette. And the second reason, because of that neoprene material, there's quite a lot of padding inside the shoe. So on top of the narrowness and the slenderness of the silhouette, do go up half a size. Third and final reason, the most shallow reason, is for my wide fat feet. Jordan 7, because of the shape, if I went true to size, from a bird's eye view, looking down, it's the same problem with the Jordan 6s. If I went true to size, it just looks too fat. The spillover is, it's disgusting. I'm disgusted by myself when I look down and I see that fat spillover. So just for that alone, for the aesthetics alone, I don't care if it was too loose, I do go up half size for Jordan 7s. And that's the reason why I don't own too many Jordan 7s. In a vacuum, just looking at the silhouette, I really like the shape, but on my feet, doesn't look that good. Now I do have to point out the ankle. If you don't wear like ankle socks at least, this part, it's not very well padded. Actually, there's no padding on this part at all. It's just like straight up leather. So if you don't wear like higher socks, that might bother you. Apart from that, the comfort of the Jordan 7s, like I said before, the padding inside, it's really nice. Wraps around your feet, even though I do go up half a size, so it's not as snug as I would like it to be. If you don't have wide feet, it's a very comfortable shoe. Now that brings the total sole score of the Jordan 7 white infrared to 16 out of 25. Right around the middle, slightly below average out of all the shoes that I've reviewed. Colorway wise, I think this is a really, really nice colorway, and it's where the shoe shines. White infrared Jordan 6s are popular for a reason, and it's because the infrared and a predominantly white sneaker just works super well together. Material wise, if the leather didn't come in this overdone tumbled leather texture, I would have given it like a 4 out of 5 or 5 out of 5. Because I do like the leather, it's nice and soft, it's genuine leather, and I love that neoprene material. But this tumbled leather is just... talk about going overboard. Comfort wise, in my opinion, the Jordan 7, one of the more comfortable shoes, owing to that neoprene material. I really dig that neoprene material. And the cushioning is really decent, not flat like the Jordan 1s or like a Nike Air Force 1 or a Nike Dunk Low. Really, really comfortable shoe. It's just a shame my feet are just shaped the way it is. Can't get the sizing perfect for a Jordan 7. Would be a more comfortable shoe if I didn't have wide feet, but you're given the cards that you dealt. Versatility wise, in my opinion, even though this is still a pretty basketball looking shoe, I think it's still pretty versatile. Because of how simple and sleek the silhouette is, I think it's quite wearable. And the colorway, there's no words to describe the versatility of this colorway. Predominantly white, hints of infrared and black. Super versatile. If it wasn't a shoe that was just like, obviously a basketball or athletic shoe, I think it'll be more versatile. It would have given a 5 out of 5. But because of that, 4 out of 5 I think is a good score. Storytelling wise, there's no story to tell. Just takes from an OG colorway, dump it on the shoe. That's it. Sometimes reusing an OG colorway on another shoe doesn't look quite right. Like the Jordan 1 True Blues, there's something about that shoe, it was a nice shoe, but just didn't really hit. The Jordan 3 True Blues were just so much nicer. They should have just left the True Blue alone. However, I do admit the white infrared on the Jordan 7s, it actually worked pretty well. So that's it. Thanks for watching, Soul Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 7 white infrared. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.